Les questions d'interaction entre la santé publique
interaction between the public health and biodiversity is an essential issue, which should be looked at in a much more accurate way, and it has been so for a few years because we're starting to measure the impact of climatic deregulation and biodiversity erosion. Human beings have always lived in a bacterial environment. There are more bacteria in a human being than cells, but men have been contaminated by pathogens coming from animal species to begin with. People think of monkeys, but not so many diseases came from monkeys, but domestic animals. Yes, 30,000 years ago, the dogs was domesticated. More recently, goats, sheep, cows, cats, horses, later, more recently, rabbits, and promiscuity in farms triggered interactions between organisms and pathogens. A human baby gut has been sequenced, and adult gut as well, and we found that there was room for 2,000 different bacterial species, and we are aware of only 500. So inside us, this is a very close environment to us. We have things we don't even know, and because we're taking too many antibiotics nowadays, this is changing the bacteria on our skin and in the digestive tube. New diseases are appearing. This has been discussed regarding obesity, some very interesting work showing that intestinal gut bacteria are a defense tool against pathogens, and there are defense genes against pathogens. So this changes all the time, and man needs to modify the relationship it has with these forms of living beings. Interestingly, in this general background, there are new diseases that are appearing, or there is different susceptibility to some diseases. Man is now creating the conditions for pathogen dissemination and virulence, parasitic diseases, infectious diseases, and autoimmune diseases. We have understood over the last 50,000 years that human beings were initially contaminated by pathogens coming from animals, and then from animal to human, and from a human being to another human being, and then human beings between themselves. And nowadays, in order to find pathogens such as syphilis, there are diseases that only contaminate the human species and no other species. The integration of mankind in biodiversity leads to interactions whereby the situation changes. And for instance, nosocomial diseases in the hospital wards are worrying because there is one or two pathogens left, very banal, Aeromonas, Pseudomonas, or Staph aureus, but they are very resistant to all antibiotic treatments. In the future, we need to start managing in a different way the relationship between biodiversity, the impact of climatic changes, and public health. The climatic changes leads mosquitoes to migrate towards the north, for instance, bringing with them other pathogens. The tiger mosquito has now settled down in the Camargue area in the southern part of France, all around the Mediterranean, and this is going to bring chikungunya to France. Well, malaria has not yet reached our coast, but well, there used to be malaria in the time. So these interactions evolve, and they are very interesting to understand. There are new diseases, age-related diseases, because man lives longer, and this has led to the emergence of diseases which were not known until now. The interaction between the climatic changes, the public health and biodiversity are really a hot topic right now.